Hi, this is Raphael Mudge, the creator of Cobalt Strike. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate the PowerShell hooks in Cobalt Strike 3.12. Here we are in Kali Linux. Let's go right over to the script. I happen to have PowerShell.cna open. And this code is what you would find in the resource kit that demonstrates these PowerShell hooks. By the way, if you go to Help Arsenal from Cobalt Strike, you can download the resource kit that has this code. All right, back to the script. Here we are. PowerShell download cradle influences the form of the download cradle used in Beacon's automation. Beacon, when it has a script that is too large to fit in a single PowerShell command, it hosts the script on a localhost only web server and uses the download cradle to grab that script from itself. And that's very much a Cobalt Strike thing. So the PowerShell download cradle hook lets you change the form of this download cradle, and you can obfuscate it to your heart's content if you're dealing with a static signature that's using the download cradle as an indicator of malicious activity. So that's one of the hooks. The other one is PowerShell command. And PowerShell command lets you influence the form of the PowerShell command line used throughout Beacon's automation. There's one form for commands that are run locally, like PowerShell, spawn as, spawn u, elevate UAC token bypass. There's another form used for lateral movement. So if you use psexec PowerShell, this is the form of the PowerShell command. And you actually get the script unencoded, so you can transform it to the encoded command form as well and do stuff to it before you do that. So that's the PowerShell command hook. Let's do a quick demo of what it would look like to benefit from these hooks in an operation. Here we are in Cobalt Strike, and I'm going to interact with this beacon, the user WhatAHog. And I happen to know that WhatAHog is a local admin on the system file server. And we can verify that by just listing the contents of $CDOLLAR on the file server system. Now, let's go ahead and try to jump over to the file server system with psexec PowerShell, and we'll target the namepipe beacon listener. And I fully expect this to fail. You may be asking why. Well, this is a stock Cobalt Strike instance. I don't have an obfuscated resource kit, and the default configuration of the server and the default procs that are present on that server will identify the script that injects the beacon payload into memory is malicious. And that product happens to have visibility into our script, even though it's not touching disk, because of a technology called AMSI, which is anti-malware scan interface. It's a hook that lets PowerShell v5 and later lets anything run by those PowerShell engines be analyzed by the security product on the system. So one way to get past this, besides obfuscating the script itself, which is an option, one way to get past this is to downgrade to PowerShell v2 if it's present, because PowerShell v2 does not happen to have AMSI. So how can we check if PowerShell v2 is present? Well, I happen to have found a blog post from Microsoft that talks about the deprecation of PowerShell v2. And if you're dealing with a Windows server, you can use a commandlet called get Windows feature to find out. So let's go ahead and do that. We're going to use the PowerShell command in Beacon. We'll do invoke command, file server, or excuse me, invoke command, computer name, file server. An invoke command lets us request that a remote system run a PowerShell commandlet and give output back to us over WinRM, which I do have enabled for this demo. So we're going to do invoke command to run our desired commandlet, which is get Windows feature on the system file server. And give it a minute. And we will get back an answer that tells us that the feature, the Windows PowerShell tool engine, is indeed installed on this particular server. That's great. That's great for us. So let's come back over to our aggressor script that has these PowerShell hooks in it. And let's change PowerShell command to add a dash version 2 to our PowerShell command line when we're doing lateral movement. And that will make it so that our attempts at lateral movement happen to downgrade to PowerShell v2. Now let's come back to Cobalt Strike. And I'm going to temporarily load this script by going to View Script Console. I'm just going to do load PowerShell.cna. And now let's try that lateral movement command again, psexec PowerShell. Remember, it failed the first time. But this time, it's going to have that version 2 flag. And there we go. We got our session on this Windows 2016 server without the need to obfuscate Cobalt Strike's PowerShell script templates, all by just simply downgrading to PowerShell version 2. So that's some of the power you get thanks to these new hooks in Cobalt Strike 3.12. I hope you enjoyed this demonstration. Good luck and happy hacking.